दृश्यम प्ले हमारी कोशिश है. हम लोगों को ऐसा लगता है कि न्यू टैलेंट, न्यू पीपल हु एक्चुअली आर वेरी टैलेंटेड बट दे डोंट नो कहाँ से म्यूज़िक बनाए, कैसे आप तक हम तक पहुँचा जाए. तो हमने जब ये प्रॉपर्टी क्यूरेट की, हमें लगा जिस तरह से हम सिनेमा को सपोर्ट करते हैं, एटलीस्ट दृश्यम फिल्म्स बिलीव इन द काइंड ऑफ सिनेमा विच इज़ वेरी विच इज़ नॉट मेन स्ट्रीम बॉलीवुड. दैट्स वाई आई थिंक वी एम्फसाइज ऑन इंडी सिनेमा. We thought we should replicate the same ideology in music, and hence Drishyam Play was born.
We felt that there is a need to do something in this space, as we felt for films. So we felt that music, and which you can see, and I am very blunt on this, that even big films don't shy away from taking some old songs and remixing, which is like shame, which is a shame on the filmmakers, and it's also shame on us. That we cannot deliver genuine music, or we are in a stage where we can't even, it seems as if we can't deliver genuine music, or we can't write genuine lyrics. But the truth is exactly opposite, because there are so many people who are ready to write, who are ready to compose, who are ready to sing, but they can't reach, they don't have a platform.
So we started with Sufi, Rab Jogi's. I think we both loved the song. The first time Manish heard the song, he was like, I want it. That was his statement. Yeah.
Because we don't have Coke.
yeah,
we have Drishyam. That's the biggest difference. But of course, Coke Studio over a period of time have created a benchmark.
Yes.
Especially Coke Studio Pakistan.
Yeah.
It's created a benchmark. I don't know, even if we get 20-30% of that level, I think we would have succeeded.
Yeah.
No, if you see our films, whatever we have produced, whether it's Aankhon Dekhi, or whether it's Masaan, or whether it's Dhanak, or whether it's Waiting, or Rukh, or even Newton, we have had beautiful soundtracks, beautiful. And some of the amazing soundtracks of those particular years where we have come in. So we have enough appetite for that, and the next films what we are making, the 6-7 films which we are making, also has enough scope for it. And as I said earlier, that we are also ready to lend it to other filmmakers if they deem fit and they need it, and we are almost open for that also. So we'll find a space for these songs.
So it's Drishyam Play is a process actually, where we are focusing on poetry a lot. We are not letting anything and everything come out because we realize that there are a lot of meaningless songs and lyrics coming out. So I think the main ingredient of a song is the poetry. Manish himself is a writer and he writes beautifully, so we understand the importance of those words coming out in a song.
I'm still in 70s, 80s and 90s.
That's right, that's great. That's the best music.
Yeah.
I think when I heard Tu Kisi Rel Si Guzarti Hai from
Masaan,
it was Dushyant Kumar's poetry. Mm-hmm. I was like, okay, Manish's taste is that, you know, that old school music.
Even Aankhon Dekhi, I think it is very underrated music, this thing, but I think nobody explored it. I think they have one of the best. It's one of my favorites too.
I come from a family where my dad used to listen to Malika Bukhraj and Begum Akhtar, so I'm more into ghazals. Mehdi Hasan Saab is what I really love, and my favorite one was Ab Ke Bichhde To Shayad Phir Khwabon Mein. And me and my husband, we still love that old school ghazals.
Music, I write from Film Guide. I think one of the best music still in my years is Guide.
Yeah.
And then all Kishore Kumar songs, Adi Barman music, even Mukesh, all Mukesh songs,
yeah.
I named them. So that time it was not album, it was more like films.
Yeah.
And then we used to get recorded the cassettes.
Yeah.
Selected our own songs. So we used to get those collections based on Kishore Kumar, Adi Barman, Rajesh Khanna songs.
Yeah.
So that way we created our own albums.
Yeah, make your own compilation.
Yes. And there used to be huge business out of it. Yeah. Aashiqui?
Oh yeah. Yeah, actually.
One or two.
I said Aashiqui, no number.
But yeah, Aashiqui was, if I'm not wrong, Aashiqui was the songs were made first and then the movie was made, right? So I think that does.
Aashiqui is an album which I can go anytime I would like to. I think I remember Jagjit Singh, I have watched a couple of times. Rest other concerts, I don't go. I'm prefer listening soulful music at home.
I have heard a lot of bands basically, you know, back in the day when Midhiman Pandits used to play with and that's the kind of collaboration when we talk about fusion. Midhiman Pandits doing this Karshka Pepon. So I still remember I attended this festival back in the day in Delhi, Garden of Five Senses. And when it comes to ghazal, I really don't like someone like, you know, touching ghazals, but I was surprised the way they did it. It was Galib's Har Ek Baat Pe Kehne Mein
and
Papon and Karsh Kale, and I was surprised what they are doing with ghazals. It was amazing. So that one concert, because it changed my view of looking at a ghazal. You can be like really experimenting with ghazal and it can sound amazing at the same time. Yeah.